Sup guys?
Jamani here.
And to die, I want to be the first person to do the first official video on Fullest House. Now, Fullest House has ended, and I already want to get talking on the sequel show. So, I'm going to be talking about a few things on what I would like to see in the sequel show, which should be the last one. Because where are they going to go at the Fullest House? Fulling House? See? Fullest House? Fulling House? You see? You get my point. But anyways, let's talk about what I want in the show.
All right then. On with the show.
So starting off with number one, and that is the release date. Now the release date should be September 22nd, 2030, because that's when Full House was released back in 1987. Candace said in 15 years, Fullest House should happen. But for me, I think it should be 10 years. I think that would be a good enough time for some of the kids to have kids. Jackson and Ramona were heading off to college. Well, not Jackson, but I'll get to him later. Max skipped the grade and went straight to middle school. In 10 years, I could see him running a business company like Harry. Tommy would want to be like his father. He probably wouldn't want to be a firefighter, but in the vein of saving people like his father. This leads me to number two. Before the show comes back in 10 years, I think in 5 years, the show should come back for a 2-hour special just to catch up on what they've been doing. Now, the special being on Netflix is a different matter. At the end of the special, I will promote the show returning in 2030. Plus, I want to be clear. I hope Jeff Franklin and everyone, like, somewhat plans the next 10-year journey, you know? Like, set the contracts, keep in touch with the actors, stuff like that. So, yeah. Number three is about relationships. In Fullest House, it obviously needs to have Ramona, Jackson, and Max as the new leads. Ethan should not be with Ramona when the show picks back up. The romance was so random and forced. I've yet to see not one person to say they like Ethan. There's another Ethan I don't like. Ethan from Resident Evil 7. Ethan should still be on the show, but he will most likely be the new Matt. Ramona should be with Popko. Not only do they have history, but I feel the actors have better chemistry. Like, I didn't really see any chemistry between Ramona and Ethan. I forgot their names, the actors' names I put up on the screen. But what also I would like to see is further explore the relationship between Jackson and Ramona. Still, my favorite from the two is when Ramona was copying Jackson when Lola broke up with him.
Look, Jackson, we gotta talk.
Oh my God. Don't tell me you're breaking up with me. I can change. I can change everything about me. You're the best thing in my entire life. Why, Lola?
Speaking of which, there's gotta be a love triangle between Jackson, Lola, and Rocky. And of course, Max should be with Rose. However, this leads to my number four, and that is the title of Fullest House. There needs to be a reason to justify the name. Like, Ramona or Jackson or Max don't even end up with the love interest in the future and end up marrying somebody else whose name is Fullest? That's gonna be stupid. You know what else is stupid is that DJ and Steve not being together in the first place. Instead of creating a new character named Tommy Fuller to justify the name of calling it Fuller. What? They're gonna kill off the Fullest character? And that's what brings Ramona, Jackson, and Max together. Which, by the way, Max should be the main character of the three. Let's change it up, you know? And seeing how all the characters are together at the end of Fuller House, to justify the name is to bring in more people into the house. Which means building more rooms in the house. And that means new sets. I like new sets. But yeah, let's move on to number five. So, in the second half of season 5, Joey has foreshadowed something, and it needs no introduction, and that is...
Whoa, Randy, whoa!
Whoa! Yes, and that is Stephanie wrecking Joy's car.
Through the window.
One more time.
The twins in Fuller House, the delivery was bad, but I don't want to blame them because they're kid actors. But at the same time, the Olsen twins had delivered the line nicely because that's how a kid would say that.
There's a car in the kitchen.
But I don't know. Like, I think I'll let it slide, but back to Joy. Seeing him foreshadowing it, it needs to happen. Now, should Stephanie drive it
through the window
by herself again? Should it be Stephanie's kid? Or should it be Stephanie and her kid? Like, what if Stephanie's kids are in the driver's seat, right? And Stephanie arrives home to see them in Joy's car. She goes to the passenger side, gets in the car, shuts the door, and tries to stop them. But then they back it up, backing up into the window. Joey arrives through the kitchen saying, "I'm done buying these cars. These cars are bad luck." Joey would pretty much be saying that he's not buying any more cars because Fullest House is the last show. Number 6, and that is Joey's kids being recurring characters. Calm down, ladies and gentlemen. Calm down. Y'all acting like this some Glenn and Glenda situation from Seed of Chucky. I get it. Majority of you don't like the kids, but me, I'm part of the group who thought they were just okay. I mean, the writers looked at the fans' response and say, yeah, we're not bringing them back. I mean, I would have brought them back, but made them more mature, but that wouldn't make sense. One episode, they hella crazy. The next episode, they mature. Yeah, that wouldn't work for me. Now, Fullest House, I say they definitely matured. And they look back on that incident saying, yeah, we were hella crazy, but all the kids at that age are hyped. So they kind of have an excuse. And they gotta get the original kid actors when the show comes back. That's about 4 reoccurring cast members right there. I'm surprised Ginger didn't come back. I mean, I saw a good enough response of people liking her. It's just not the kids people liked. One other thing before I move on, and that is Pam. She's gotta be a recurring character. I mean, she was named after her adoptive aunt. Pam should take up after Jesse, Becky, Michelle, Melina, and throw in some little sparkles of her own stuff in there. Plus, in Fuller House, there could be a storyline on where Pam tries to track down her parents and find out why they gave her up. Before I go, there are some smart things I would like to mention, and that is in season 5, episode 17 or 18, GJ said she was considering burning the legendary blue couch. I think that should happen, but not until the series finale of Fullest House. Jackson said he's considering skipping college to become a hacker. So I could see Jackson getting his own company, just like Max as well. Also, where was DJ getting all those banners at, bro? How is she not broke, bro? I mean, I think they made a joke about how she was paying for it, but it's still, where are you getting this money from? It's kind of like the door thing. Lock the damn door. Fernando, or I will continue to call you ass, Fandango. I hope that accent is gone. I mean, the actor is going to be much older, so hopefully it's matured or the accent is gone completely. But going back to relationships, one relationship I think didn't get enough light was Matt and Rocky. So I would like to see that get further developed in Fullest House. And this one, I just made a video on it, and it not only it doesn't need an introduction, but I need Kimmy Gibbler's mom and dad, her 3 sisters, who was mentioned in the pilot, but then was never mentioned again. But most importantly, I need Garth Gibbler to show up. Now that could either happen at Fuller's house, or it could happen in the 2-hour special. Like, come on, y'all mention the parents, but don't mention Garth. It's like he don't exist no more. They are like some of the biggest missed opportunity character storylines they could have used. But last but not least, they brought it up a lot in season 5, and I just mentioned a few minutes ago, and that is lock the damn door. I need an episode where the stuff is taken, just like the episode on Drake and Josh. Heck, bring Josh Peck back and his kid in Fullest House as well. Him and John Stamos had good chemistry, but that's all I gotta say about that. I hope the actors go on to have a successful career, but then they come back to where it all began for some of them, Fullest House. This is not my last video on the Full House universe, by the way. So, get your fingers up and say it with me. The door will always be open. Bye.
Time to end this. Can we talk? Okay. You win.
Thank you. And go tell people about my channel and to subscribe.